Sir Jet!
Yes, bro. Ano to?
Uy, teka! Jet, this is the Yamaha MT-10.
Top of the food chain.
Top of the food chain. Really? Top of the food chain?
Yes. Sa MT-Series, ito na yung pinakamataas na uri or top of the class ng MT-Series ng Yamaha.
Ah, okay, okay. Well, pag-usapan natin yung looks before we get into it, before okay. We dive into it. How does it look for you? Kamusta yung itsura niya? It's very different from the usual. Yes. So what do you think of that?
The looks is aggressive. Kasi may headlight niya, yun. Kakaiba, para siyang robot.
Yeah, what do you think of that? Is that something that you think people will like or love, hate kind of thing?
I think what's good about Yamaha is parang pumupunta sila or they go off their comfort zone.
I think that's a good thing.
Yeah, they try out new stuff, like look at the color combination.
I like it.
Diba? I mean, I think Yamaha with this bike, they're setting new trends of colors and designs sa motorcycles. Kaya ganito yung itsura.
I like that.
Kakaiba yung itsura.
Kasi at least, hindi tayo nagsasawa din sa usual flavors na nakikita natin for decades at a time.
But again, it can be a good thing or bad thing.
Yeah, yeah, yung sinasabi ko na love-hate thing. Yes. Some people may love it, some people may hate it. You know, this is one of them. I think some people might love it, like it, or hate it, or dislike it.
Everything. Yeah.
So, how about performance? You know, riding it. Kamusta naman yung... performance for you when you tried it first time.
Yeah.
First impressions riding.
May mararamdaman kang distinct na in terms of power and torque. Well, MT is called master of torque, eka nga, di ba? Pero dito sa motor na to, sa MT-10, I think, kumbaga pinanindigan ng MT-10 yung pagka-master of torque niya. Sa pakiramdam ko, naka-standby lang yung power, pero pag binira mo, bibigay talaga yung power.
You know that very distinct in such a way
that
different from other bikes I've tried. I think it's with the throttle positioning. Pag umabot siya to a certain particular throttle position, I was experimenting with it. Nag-jump yung power bigla. It reminds me of the Yamaha V-Max. It had a reputation for at a certain RPM, the power just para may boost.
Uh-oh.
And this feels like at a certain throttle position or RPM, meron siya parang bumapasok bigla yung power. And it's actually something that, again, just like the design, love or hate. Kasi some people might find it parang bakit bigla, ba't hindi na lang linear. Pero people like me, for example, I love the jump in power kasi parang konting pitik lang, whoa, andyan na lahat yung power. I don't have to dig deep dun sa throttle para habulin yung power. It's so easy to get it off.
Is it because of the cross-plane ba?
I think it is. That's the
first time ko mag-ride ng cross-plane. Yun ang naramdam ko kaiba compared sa mga inline fours na pare-pareho sports bike. Ay, may distinct silang pagkakaano, pero ito, iba.
Yeah, I studied it a little bit and I read about what Yamaha says about the crossplane. And ang ultimate result, it's all a play of counterbalance angles of the piston to the camshaft and all. It's very technical. But
ang very ultimate, technical.
Yeah, ang ultimate na result niya is a balanced, purring engine na hindi nag-vibrate masyado.
Yep.
And at the same time, because of its efficiency in the way they designed it, it delivers a bit more torque. No, okay, siguro to simplify, they've split it down into split seconds. Yung waveform ng power delivery, yung up and down ng piston. And they, put it simply, they eliminated more of those gaps dun sa pagbigay ng power ng mga piston. So they put it closer. It's not perfect.
Okay.
Even the write-ups of Yamaha themselves, may konting gaps pa rin, but they eliminated it, particularly at the lower RPM, na dun lumalabas yung torque. Kaya MT, Master of Torque, yung ginawa nila doon. Because
masyadong,
of that.
Masyadong technical yun. Pero yeah. I-imagine ko yung sinasabi mo dito sa aking think bubble, merong mga ganyan, technicals and mechanicals.
Yes, yes. Well, the only thing that's important is, does it deliver? I think it does.
I think it does. The sabi torque. Ko kanina, it's a top of the food chain. May mga kapatid itong nakababatang kapatid.
Yeah, yeah, meron din sila mga torquiness kahit pa paano. Pero this is like this is the actual MT, the master of torque. And then the others are sort of how would you call it? Derivatives of the MT.
I see.
For a smaller budget, you're too scared of the power, you don't want that too much power, so you still get the same torquiness.
Pero if you want everything.
But if you have the pure Yamaha MT experience.
Dito. Kasi I think sa standard category ng Yamaha, binigay nga nila lahat dito. The engine, the technology, the handling. Ano
yeah, speaking of handling, I mean the
suspensions.
Suspension. Speaking of handling, the corners, the highways, ultimately both of them. When you drive on the highway, acceleration very sudden. Sarap. Suspension is great, like you said. Actually, isa pa siyang distinct thing about the MT-10 is the suspension is wonderful, fully adjustable. Meron siyang tension, compression, preload in the front forks.
And then yung rear fork is adjustable.
Adjustable din siya. Fully adjustable both suspensions, front and rear. That's why ang sarap-sarap niyang gamitin.
Ang sarap niyang gamitin.
I mean, pag you experience bugs, ang sarap ng suspension niya. I mean, it's sarap nga. If you hit bumps, it's kind of stiff. You feel stiff. Pero when you're riding it the way you should, you know, like in the corners or accelerating on a straight or nag-inundate yung road.
Yeah, sinubukan yun.
You can feel this is good suspension. Yeah. Sarap-sarap na talaga.
Okay. So my question to you is, ano yung nag-stand out sa iyo? Maybe one or two or three?
Okay. Nag-stand out sa akin is primarily the
stand
design.
Out.
I love the fact that Yamaha is experimenting with these kinds of designs. And it looks good, it's impressive, it's different, and me being a creative guy myself, I appreciate that. Gusto ko yun.
Okay.
Second, yung boost ng power at a certain RPM, I love it. As in, I love it. I'm falling in love with it. It took me the whole day of riding to get used to it and put it under control.
Yeah.
Sa akin. It took me a whole day. But at the end of the day today, after riding it, it's like, okay, this is, I can manage this thing. I can control the beast. And it's so much fun.
Okay.
It's so much fun. Maninibago ka lang talaga sa simula. Those are the two for me. The design and the torque delivery at a certain RPM. I love that.
Okay.
Ikaw, what do you love about it?
Well, first, medyo na-surprise ako na gusto mo yung design. Coming from you appreciating classic bikes.
Well, you have to understand. Edgy,
very artistic. Well, you're coming from the side of artistic kasi.
Artistic, yeah.
And modern. Well, this design is, I think, for modern design.
Okay.
Pero ang nag-stand out talaga sa akin dito, number one is the suspension. Gusto ko yung suspension. Yung nag-twisties tayo, ang ganda ng laro or ganda ng play ng suspensions sa mga kurbada. And yun nga, tama rin yung sinabi mo kanina, I agree. Pareho din yung nag-stand out sa akin, it's the torque.
Correct.
Yung if you're maintaining on 4,000, 5,000 RPM and then biglang bibirahin mo na, doon, talagang bibigay. Sumisigaw. And siguro may bonus ako ng konti. Medyo gusto ko yung sound. Nagkakaiba siyang sound.
Actually, siya yung number 3 ko.
Ah, okay. Maraming tayo.
Love it.
Yung sound, iba. Compared sa mga inline 4 na iba.
Car.
Oh, this is like inline 4 din, di ba?
Inline 4.
Na cross-plane. Pero yung mga previous na ginagamit natin na inline 4, medyo pino yung tunog. Ito medyo iba. May rumble ng konti.
Yeah, it's the rumble that I love.
Oh, yan.
Para siyang combination. V-twin engine and an inline 4 at the same time. It's wonderful. Who do you think this bike is for? It's meant for?
Sige,
that's a good question. Go naman.
Una, I think this bike is also a track-capable bike.
Very, I agree.
Yun ang bibili doon. I think this is, ang bibili nito, or kukuha nito is yung mga mahihilig sa long rides. At the same time, pwedeng gamitin sa track.
Correct.
It's 2-in-1 for me. Pero hindi ko siya sinasuggest for daily. or pan-traffic.
Yeah, it got really hot.
Yeah.
Really,
that's why.
Really hot.
Especially dun sa may part ng mid seat. So yun, I think yun ang bibili doon. How about you?
I think you're right. Idadagdag ko na rin siguro yung the ones who love power.
Adrenaline junkie
and forma. Kasi yeah, because of the design thing.
Well, actually, the design will stand out talaga.
It will.
Kanina, nag-ride tayo, mandami tumitingin. Kasi, imagine mo the color. This is, I don't know, Yamaha color offers different colors pa nito.
Yes.
Pero this is, I think, gun gray or, ano yan? This is army gray.
Army gray
combined with some orange red, the bright.
Yeah.
So, lutang na lutang yung kulay.
Correct.
So, yeah. I agree with you.
Yeah. So, alright. Well, I think we agree it's a great bike it's meant for certain people.
Yep.
And it delivers strongly, highly, high grades on certain aspects.
If you wanted everything, comfort, power, stand out, sa itsura, this is the bike.
Right. On my list, siguro, this would end up between the top 6 to 10.
Mga ganun din sa
top 6, ikaw din.
Mga ganun din sa akin. Mga ganun sa akin.
You know, isa pa. The number 4, can I add number 4?
Sige, pahabol.
One last thing that I love, ang lapad ng tank, lapad ng bike.
Oh, yeah.
Comfortable. Feels like you're sitting on a horse.
Idagdag natin pala. Sa mga kurbada or sa mga twists.
Ang sarap, di ba?
Ang sarap kung makapit yung paa. May kakapitan yung paa.
Yeah, kasi wala nang galaw
yung legs. Yan yung napansin ko.
Just slide a little bit, you're
compared
there.
Compared sa mga smaller tanks, ito advantage to kasi malaki yung tank, mas may kakapitan yung tubo
na. Yeah, I love that.
Tama ka dun. I agree.
Okay. Alright, so it's getting dark. Let's call it a day. It was a great ride today.
Yeah. Yes. Very good ride.
Another bike review naman next time?
Another bike review na
to. Alright, so... See you in the next video.
See you, bro.